previously on the Farmers of Thought show.
We say no to war. We say no to nuclear weapons. We say no to silence. And as Africa, we seek to join together and come up with one military base for the African greater continent. One army, one nation, one currency, one leader.
Mara, Chigarambok, Kugaramashambahuda. Down south,
in the land,
the black rains, bees, and endangered species.
In the corridors of time, 2020, here from Farmers of Thought, down south. Welcome all.
We are not for sale.
I would not have found a better way of developing the next generation, but present this rather strange message as a person already in transit and moving between lands of philosophical contestation and discussion. I would not find a better way of giving a message for our generation as to what is it that we leave for the next. As you all have known, I've been a minister for the longest part of my life. And I would give an advice based on the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 9, where then the black book says, you know, we don't know how to pray, teach us how to pray. You know how that beautiful prayer goes on, but I'm not interested in much of the content above, as I want us to look at the conclusion of that prayer, where it says, for thine is the kingdom, for thine is the power, thine is the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I therefore want to submit to us that as Africans, we need to develop, we need to desire, we need to call for a presence of a kingdom. We need a kingdom of our own. Above the kingdom, we need the kingdom to have power that includes financial power, political power, military power, academic power, and all other forms of power. We need a kingdom. We need power. Not only power. Power will be useless if it does not go with glory, the glamour that goes with it. Admiration that goes with it. And above everything else, we need to plan kingdoms that are plugged into eternity forever and ever. So if you should ask me, what is it that we must teach our children for the next generation, I say teach them, not governments, teach them kingdom mentality. Teach them how to access and develop power, not to be servants, but how to become powerful. And over power, they must work with presence and an understanding of glory. And above glory, they must build in everything they do posterity. What happens after one generation has gone past? Therefore, our education must not only be a short-term solution to a long-term problem. We needed to start plugging our minds to how do we develop long-term solutions. The demons and the problems that we are dealing with are more than 400 years old of colonization. As a result, when we are planning our solutions, we cannot make them temporal, painkiller, panadol sort of solutions. We needed to develop a long-term solution for the long-term problem. So teach your children more about accessing that kingdom. Teach them more about how they can develop power, love for power, development for power, management of power, and preservation of that power. If you can hear very well, that develops from academics into military training. And above all else, they need to work for glory. They need to work for preservation of their own nationality, on tribal links, on Africanicity, on humanity. We need to celebrate this humanity with glory. And in all, let us build businesses, build empires, build curriculums, build industries, build families that will not only last for one generation, but that will grow from one generation to the other, into the millennium of unending pools of knowledge. To that space of fatherhood, I invite everyone, one and all. If you don't have time to bring them up, do not bring them in. Yours truly, Maponga J, Farmers of Thought. Farmers of Thought.
Felix Maponga Photography.